This is Debashis from Faruque.
Thank you for giving the floor. This at last. Thank you especially thanks to keynote speaker, which actually covering all the points mostly, and thereafter we discuss a lot. And everything has been discussed, I think. I just want to point out two, three things. As we discuss about the CEBAI, now CEBAI is under tremendous pressure because so many expectations from the CEBAI. But we need to know what is actually means, what is the limitation CEBAI has. I think that is one point we need to understand, that we need to know what we don't know actually, unknown. So that is also one point. So the expectation is too much. Expectation is too much because our target is a big target, but achievable. That is, it's a demandable, achievable. Is that again reasonable also? But here we face some challenges, definitely some challenges. Out of that, nothing is left. We know. I'm as an executive director working, also looking into the sales and marketing, where I face every season reduction of the prices. Still, I want to thanks to the buyer that they are giving me all, and we are still running our projects. Thanks for that. But really, only thing left is the productivity and the waste reduction. Nothing is left there. But the positive things is, there is a path. We have a problem with our utilization of the resources, like the manpower as well as the all kind of resources, like water, electricity, everything, gases, everything. We have wastage of the high level. So we can reduce this. And CEBAI can work on this. Again, I have also expectation to the CEBAI. Having the limitation, I don't know how many limitations they have. The skill development is, as I always think it, that this is the training unit, but training as CEBAI is itself excellence. So excellence is not an, actually it is not an act, it is the excellence. So you need to have that with the training and the reputation of the things and the habituation concepts. And at end of the day, it is transforming as a success, as a manifestation of the success. So skill development, to be the core, but where there will be the skill development is going on, process, training, everything, we have to keep in our mind with the sustainability. We have to keep alongside the sustainability. So that is my suggestions. We don't want, again we have got a three top class factories in Bangladesh, we are right for that, but at the same time we don't want any further repeat of any small incident like that. That we don't want. So every time if you want to increase your productivity and waste reductions, everything, you want to make your profit in your business, you have to have your working condition is good. So CEBAI has to keep in mind, wherever there is a training and everything, sustainability in every aspect, keep in mind. So here, as our Babu Lakha, Mr. Babu, I'm just finishing in 1 minute. Babu Lakha said that the scarcity is and all. Why the scarcity will be here? If we can manage, as Mr. Ayush also said that, why we cannot find out what is the reason behind of the fighting against the worker and the owners? We need to have a proper social dialogue. So social dialogue can be one issue. Can be CEBAI also keep in our mind, how can I make this social dialogue inside the worker and the that can be one issue. And we have got many other challenges are there, but many other challenges are there, but we do not have to forget that. We have got a huge potential country where we have got 60% of our workers are, or not workers, our populations are 25 to 30. So there is a huge potential we have to take the dividend out of it. So CEBAI can work on that. But finally, again, I can share one thing. The 50 billion is big, but if only garment, how many pieces we do not know. But as our neighboring country is exporting CEO of the garment, why not we are thinking about the CEO of the garment exporting, not the garment? Is there any plan of CEBAI that exporting not garment, also CEO of the garment? Thank you very much.
Thank you, Debashis. Basically, you know, last week, the chief of ILO, the DG of ILO was here, and we had, during that few days, we have discussed many things about social dialogue.